7 tries in the doing. It's autumn today. The start by Craig Chalmers. It was a very good kick-off indeed, but Van der Vest hastened right away with that high kick, and it's a very good one. He bounced it in play. So a splendid start for the South African scrum half. So the first line out of the match, just 5 metres outside the Barbarians, 22. New back at the tail for the Barbarians, but driving through Dalton. Pick up there, and the drive by Kruger, having got the ball from Durant. There's the drive on again, Kruger once more. Inside the 22, Leroux onto Pienaar. Pienaar driving to the line, a magnificent drive of the South African captain. Van der Vesthuizen once again out there nicely. It's going to be a try for Kruger. And Kruger scores a splendid try. It's his third of the tour. They've just played 1 minute. And it was magnificent build-up. Ruben Kruger, who's been one of the great successes on the tour so far. Van der Vesthuizen, who's looked for space all through this tour. The link man was Gavin Johnston. And there was no stopping Kruger.
Yeah, we see it here that Johnson feeding onto Kruger, who'd featured previously in about two or three of the drives that sucked in the Barbarians' defence, and that's the last thing the Barbarians would have wanted, a start like that, and perfect for the Springboks. But good work at the front of the line-out by Dalton, the hooker, who picked up the loose ball that enabled South Africa to attack them.
So we thought that Gavin Johnson would be doing all the goal-kicking for the South Africans, but of course this is the good side for André Joubert. Not quite good enough, being the left-footer, but that's a very good start indeed for the South Africans. Joubert there with 75 points from the 7 games, and you can see how Van der Vesthuizen has threatened all through this tour. Lovely linkage by Gavin Johnson, a fullback, and the flanker out there on the narrow side, a ploy the South Africans have used a lot. The rolling, driving maul. Kubus Vise in the van of that one, the huge lock forward. Now it's Leroux along the line there to Muller Peter. Thumping tackle by Scott Hastings. Moving the ball on the ground after the tackle, and it's a penalty to the Barbarians. But that was a very typical Scott Hastings tackle. And he certainly made his point. The midfield, of course, will have to be very aware and very powerful in their defence, because the South Africans clearly are going to move the ball wide. That's Peter Durant, this big loose head prop forward who's had a lick in the elbow. And Jonathan Callard is the man deputed to take the Barbarians' kicks. And what a start he had to his international career. 3 caps so far, 39 points. Callard has got it high, but it's just wide. As always, one touch judge close to a post and the other one deep to cover all eventualities. Van der Vesthuizen was prepared to take a quick tap, but it's given to Henny Leroux. A lovely restart by him high. Could have been maybe a bit further forward, taken by Andrews. Valley Schwart there putting the bulwark in front of him. Going up the side there, and as I thought, Durant has been injured, and it is that right elbow. But that is the new law this season that says that at the Rucker Mall, you have to go in level with or behind the rear feet.
I think it's crucial for the Barbarians forwards to try and get a bit of ball, that they're scratching around for possession at the moment. And I see South Africa have shortened the lineouts, and because they got wiped out of the lineouts last Saturday down at the Arms Park against Wales. So the only success that they did have was when they shortened the lineouts, and they've gone straight back to this.
Andrews went up for it, taken there by Rob Wainwright. He's caught by Van der Vesthuizen right up to the 22. He stayed on his feet so well, the Scottish breakaway man, Robert Jones, dummying, and that speed of Robert Jones, 10-15 metres short. Panic stations here for the South Africans. and Wainwright once again through on Dalton. Went forward. Advantage to the South Africans. It was a tremendous run initially by Wainwright, and there again he was in on the tackle as Dalton saved. Strong South African scrummage, and Joubert with the beautiful left footer. And it's a superb kick. How he does that with his left foot to the left touchline and so close to it at the start. Quite incredible. Undoubtedly the star of this tour, André Joubert. And there's the view from our high camera behind the posts. That's at the Lansdowne Road end. And an absolute pack here in this, the oldest of all the international grounds. Big jump by Ian Jones.
Both sides have actually got front jumpers playing the second row. Mark Andrews for South Africa, who's been quite successful at the front of the line, is now jumping in the middle. And both Ian Jones and Simon Shaw are front jumpers and going to operate from the middle.
South Africans, as always, the heavier by quite a bit. Van der Westhuizen, a little move there with Pienaar, the captain. But it broke down with a quick pass to Henry Leroux, and the Barbarians have won a good ball. Robert Jones, it's a very useful kick. In comes Chester Williams. He's quite remarkable under the high ball, that lad. Now it's out to Tian Strauss, going up to halfway. Hands on to Kubus Wiese, 19 and a half stones. Leroux, lovely dummy by Mulder. Mulder almost knocked down by Wood, the hooker, up to the Barbarians 22. But again, the Barbarians winning useful ball. Craig Chalmers with a most un-Chalmers-like kick, but the ball went forward and there was no advantage from the kick. Craig Chalmers there with 36 caps for Scotland. He missed only one of the first 35. And they'll have to come away across the field to the right, because Chester Williams was injured in collecting that high up and under. Survive in the middle, but that one to the back. Pienaar managed to get a hand to it first of all, but good by the Barbarians. Out to Wood, and Wood, the Irish hooker, getting into the 22. Robert Jones Burrows. Jones again, drive on there by big Peter Cloese, the tight head prop forward. Offside against the South Africans. And Robert Jones, who has played four times for the Barbarians against major tour sides, and this is the second time that he's captained them. But this is a fellow who excites an Irish crowd whenever he has the ball in his hands. Keith Wood, whose late father Gordon played in this match in 1961, when the Barbarians beat the South Africans by 6-0. And by a coincidence, on that day, the Barbarians had an all-Irish front row, just as they have today. Ronnie Dawson and Sid Miller were with Gordon Wood in 1961, and today we have Popplewell, Keith Wood and Cloese. They've played 10 minutes. Jonathan Callard, remember his four penalty goals when England beat the All Blacks in his first international. Oh, he's made a right hutch of that one. That was Mulder with the kick, half charged down by Al Sharon. Callard is in there. That kick by Jonathan Callard was rather like a number four Wood that you or I might hit, Bill.
I don't think ours would be that good, Bill, but Jonathan Callard would be very disappointed indeed with that he's eager to regain his England place that Paul Hull's taken now, and goal kicking has been one of his fortes, but he's had a disappointing start with his kicks.
Scrummaging is very interesting, because of course this is a very strong and powerful scrummaging Irish front row, and it'll be interesting to see what kind of a test they can set for the South Africans, who perhaps aren't quite the scrummagers as of old. When South African tour sides came here in the past, they used to scrummage everybody into the ground, but not quite the same now. Henny Leroux, who played as a centre against Argentina in one of the internationals before the tourists came over here, back in the old stand at standoff. Good deflection by Ian Jones. Pienaar going through. Wainwright has laid it nicely. Robert Jones once again. Joubert waits. He knew he had to jump for it. Gagan was up on him, but Joubert did wonderfully well. There's another bit of marvellous footballing skill. He was caught, he was put down in the tackle, he released it, got to his feet, and got the ball again. Every bit of it according to law.
Yes, I think a lot of sides saw that Joubert was slightly fallible under the high ball, but down in Cardiff he was, but certainly I think he'd been practicing this week and he did well then.
15 metres from the South African line. Rob Wainwright trying to hold it in, but it goes out to Chalmers, to Scott Hastings. That's a switch to Gagan. Gagan coming in, but very well tackled by Mulder. Still inside the South African 22. Now it's Van der Westhuizen. This is where they love to attack. It's Muller, Peter Muller. He's a big, strong 14 and a half stone centre out there to Gavin Johnston. And that was a very good tackle indeed by Philippe Saint-André, the French captain. But a lovely move, and just the kind of exciting adventurism that the South Africans have been showing whenever they had the chance. Robert Jones, Chalmers, no way through there. Tian Strauss with the tackle. Henny Leroux was on hand as well.
But I think in hindsight that Craig Chalmers might be looking back at that and thinking, well, why didn't I move it? Because a couple of the South African centres were involved in the ruck there and he had a chance of an overlap.
Robert Jones, Chalmers missed out to Hastings. Goes to Hall. Mike Hall, who had a great game for Wales against the South Africans, on to back. Almost up to the 22 again. Robert Jones once again, Chalmers. Gagan, chance for Scott Hastings. Hastings well tackled by Muller again. Gagan, Joubert in on the tackle in that time. And once again, Bill, really remarkable South African defence.
Yeah, very good cover indeed. That it really needs somebody to straighten the line. That Gagan did well to keep on his feet, but good defence there because Joubert not only tackled Gagan, but he turned him in the tackle as well. But from the ensuing ruck, the Barbarians have got a penalty, and it looks as though Robert Jones is going to run this one.
So we're going to have one of those funny little ones. It's a question who gets the ball, really. Closey on the dummy run. Robert Jones onto Al Sharon, the big Canadian. Onto Simon Shaw of Bristol, the huge youngster, the 20-year-old. Worked back from Popplewell. Jones, Scott Hastings switching. Out to Wood. Good tackle by Dalton. Still deep inside the South African 22. But once again, the South Africans have won it. Joubert on the right foot that time with a long cross kick. Beautifully positioned. Across comes Callard. Callard caught by Joubert. Knocked over by Pinard. That's the Barbarians 22. And that is really typical of the South Africans, attacking so often out of defence.
Yes, a bit surprising that Joubert kicked it then because it had a fair overlap, but I think Jonathan Callard has taken a knock here, and he would have been hindsight, he would have been better putting the ball actually off the field, and the referee had just blown his whistle when the ball was coming out for the South African, but really Callard should have put that off the park.
Good scrummage by the South Africans, and the Westhuizen gets it back from the room. Joubert was there, but cutting across and obstructing. Perhaps not deliberate, but it still does affect the defensive positioning of the team without the ball. And of course, it's a penalty offence. Craig Chalmers here, who's got something to prove after not being quite at his best against the South Africans at Murrayfield. Well, that's certainly the best one of the day so far. Monstrous kick by Chalmers. There he is checking again on what kind of move. The Barbarians, as I say, have just had two training sessions. Not easy to build up things with players from seven different countries. But they're making a very good fist of it so far. And territorially, they've done as well, if not better, than the South Africans. But for Ireland, Hobus Wiese, huge man, but nicely knocked back there from Shaw. Jones, Chalmers, Paul is screened through to the 22, on to Back once again. Wonderful positioning and support work by Neil Back, but he was holding on the floor. Penalty to South Africa. They won't rush this one. Joubert once again. Another howitzer kick by him.
Switch.
Taken by Callard. Callard to Gagan. Gagan half caught by Henny Leroux. Caught by Andrews. That's the Bavarians 22. Jones, Chalmers. Chalmers thumped down by Kian Strauss. Loose awkward ball taken by Ian Jones. Jones on to Shaw. All very scattered at the moment, but the referee saw people going in from the side instead of coming in level with the rear man or behind him. So Jonathan Callard will be very keen indeed to put this one over. This is his third shot. And as I was telling you, in his three internationals, four penalty goals against New Zealand, five against Scotland, four against Ireland last season. Callard then, oh, he's clapped that one as well. And he's absolutely disgusted with himself. So it's a problem for Robert Jones. Does he keep Jonathan Callard on as kicker and hope that he gets his range and direction? Or does he switch maybe to Craig Chalmers? We'll see. Leroux with the restart. Charon with the catch. Lovely ball for the Barbarians. Jones to Chalmers. That's a really good Gary Owen just in front of the post. Joubert, well positioned. Both feet on the ground that time. And they're taking it so quickly. He's gone again. Back after him. But look at the pace of the big man. Henny Leroux with the kick. Callard with the catch. Wood can charge. You would hear the crowd roar as soon as he got the ball, the hooker. Chalmers, Charon going back. Great tackle by Kian Strauss. Dalton feeds it out to Van der Westhuizen. Awkward ball. Callard is back in support. But it's taken by Saint-André. Callard thumped down by Pinard on the Barbarians' 10 metres line. South Africans may have won this one. Van der Westhuizen gets the service. Mulder. Out to Muller. Peter Muller. The link there to Kruger wasn't quite good enough. Gagan trying to counter-attack. Joubert's pass to Kruger wasn't good enough. Van der Westhuizen trying an arrow side. Good tackle by Jones. Inside the Barbarians 22. Kruger trying to get it. Van der Westhuizen, Leroux. On to Strauss. Strauss well thumped down there, but they're deep inside. There, the Barbarians 22. A loud blast because the South Africans took it in, didn't recycle it. Barbarians get the foot in.
The Barbarians did well then because they slowed the South African ball down all the time, which enabled their midfield backs to regroup. And it looks as though Chester Williams, the left winger, who's had an outstanding tour, is coming off the field.
So we're feeling that a big youngster called Otto may be coming on the field for the South Africans. In actual fact, the public address people have made the mistake. The South African replacements are not numbered as per program, and so that's where the problem was. But it is Joel Stransky who is on. Jones again with an awkward high Gary Owen. Stransky was underneath it, but a great catch there by Joubert, who's really showing the right kind of technique now, because if the opposition are close, you really have to get up off the ground, and he's doing that.
Yes, because you cannot be tackled whilst you're airborne, and that is the key to it. That's why you see fullbacks nowadays jumping for the ball, and that's a good start by the substitute Stransky there, that it probably feels a bit more familiar in the standoff position than he does on the left wing.
He's been a remarkable scorer. He's scored, what, 903 points in 72 games for Natal. Prolific scorer and very quick off his mark as well. Popplewell surveys the scene. Chalmers did well. Burst to it and got his body over the ball. Dalton was offside, yes. He was straying up the side. Referee playing advantage. Callard with the long kick and a very good one. The referee decided that was a good enough advantage. And so that'll hearten Jonathan Callard after his three missed goal kicks.
So one of the delights of the game is actually seeing the passing of Robert Jones at scrum half, because he has no wind-up at all. He's probably the quickest passer of the ball in the British Isles, and I think he'll be relishing this opportunity to show the Welsh selectors that he's still around and playing decent rugby.
And Bill, it's the distance of the pass as well. Chalmers is about 25 yards away. So important to a stand-up half to get a quick pass. And here we go again. Look, the quick movement, just a wrist flick. Scott Hastings driving in just to give his forwards a target. Neil Back was there first. It fed out from Popplewell. Clawsey on the charge. The ruin on the tackle that time inside the South African 22. And so Nick Popplewell there, who's another great favourite and who is, of course, has changed his club as well. He's playing for Wasps now. Has played for the South African universities. He's another one, 6 feet seven, 17 stones. He's just 21. Clearly has a very good appetite. Just inside the South African 22, and a great shove there by the Barbarians, but the South Africans held it and they controlled their delivery as well. The long pass there, a chance for Philippe Saint-André. The French captain has scored. The crowd roaring here. Pure opportunism. The man who has made and has scored some of the most sensational tries for France has tied the score. 5-5.
I see a bit of complacency here from the South Africans that Joubert does a double miss here. The ball doesn't go to hand, but just look how well Saint-André picks his ball up, because he still needs a bit of scoring. One movement, picked it up. Good try by him.
It was a risky one. The pass just faded away from Peter Muller, and Mulder couldn't control it on the ground. Saint-André could. Brilliant player. Remember how he finished off that marvellous try against England at Twickenham in 91, started by Serge Blanco, almost in his own dead ball line. And it's through. That'll be a great lift for Jonathan Callard. The conversion is over. The Barbarians are in the lead. What a lift that'll be for the Bath fullback. And see here, Joubert was in the standoff position. If Muller had got it, he might well have been clean through. Mulder couldn't kill the ball on the floor. And Saint-André just needed a sniff of a chance.
I've heard a lot about this young Irish hooker, and certainly he's impressed me, Keith Woodies, and he's apparently one of the quickest players in the Gary Owen club, that he sort of beats all the backs of sprinting. And he had an outstanding tour to Australia, playing in two tests down there, and I really enjoyed his performance this afternoon.
Dalton's throw. Very good effort by Andrews with his body arched backwards. But the Barbarians have won a good ball. Jones trying to go, Strauss catches him. Pick up and drive there, or the attempted drive by Manson Bishop. Now it's Chalmers. Joubert. Van der Westhuizen. He is so strong. And there could be a loud blast for a late charge and a late tackle. Van der Westhuizen definitely taken out. And he was given a pretty hefty thump and took a dim view. Neil Back being told that the tackle was late and dangerous. So a chance for the South Africans to edge in front again. Meanwhile, Van der Vesthuizen has had a bit of attention. Seems to be all right. One or two boos around the ground, but it's understandable that the South Africans would want to get their noses in front again. Gavin Johnson is the fellow who's been deputed to take this kick, and he's done some splendid scoring on this tour, 64 points in 7 games, and he's also scored 35 points in his 3 test matches, and he equaled the record of 22 points in a test match. Gerard Bosch and Joe Stransky are the other South Africans with that record. Gavin Johnston then, it's beautifully pulled round, but not well enough. Both Dutch judges having a good look at each other. It was a good kick. He was practicing for a long time on the ground yesterday. But it stays 7 points to 5 for the Barbarians. They've about 10 minutes to go to half time.
And I think you'll see the Springboks play a far tighter game now. They've tried opening it out on their own line. It's cost them a try. And I think the forwards are saying, right, lads, let's keep the ball close to us for a bit.
Wood again. Look how quick he is. Got there by Schwart. Over the halfway line. Manson Bishop again. Great work by the Barbarians. Forwards driving. Wainwright was going there. Ian Jones helped him. Dalton on the counter-attack. And this big fella, Guy Manson Bishop, is certainly making his presence felt. He's just been with Newport for a couple of months. He's another just 21.
He didn't make the tackle.
South African 10 metres line. Pick up by Strauss. Van der Vesthuizen back inside. Meant for again Henny Leroux. The ball went forward, no advantage. The Barbarians with the put in. They're getting tremendous support from the Lansdowne Road crowd. 50,000 packed in here, and they're enjoying it. Jones, Chalmers, beautifully to Hall. Philippe Saint-André was there. Gagan couldn't quite control it, but a very good move indeed. The left wing across in a kind of right centre position. I've got Simon Gagan here. Remember his first cap in 91 against France, and then he scored a try in each of the next 3 internationals on the trot. Wales, England and Scotland conceded them. It's another big fella there, Simon Shaw. He's 20, 6 feet 9, 19 stones. Did well, got a bit of a ricochet. Lucy helping to pull them forward. Wood with the drive, almost managing to get out at the other side. Jones, Chalmers, dummy run by Scott Hastings. Hall takes it on the South African 22, back wins it. Callard, Saint-André, Gagan twisting and turning. He's like a mad trout up a burn, that laddie with the blonde hair. There's a drive on by Popplewell. Saint-André, good tackle by Van der Vesthuizen. Deep inside the South African 22, alarm bells ringing here out from Ian Jones. Scott Hastings going, tackled by Henny Leroux and by Tian Strauss. And Pienaar's on the wrong side. And that was a rousing bit of play, and the Barbarians have got a penalty out of it. They really are taking the game to the South Africans, no doubt.
And it's all started, Bill, with the Irish front row have suddenly in the last 10 minutes have decided that they want to get involved in this game, and they've started picking loose ball up and driving at the Springboks. And in the past, the South Africans have been spreading across the field and not defending the heart of Wrexham Mall. So the Barbarians have taken advantage of this. But really, I think in football jargon, you say by Francois Pienaar that was a professional foul. That he could see that the Barbarians are going to win the ball. He's probably happier to concede 3 rather than a try, which is 5.
Francois Pienaar, who's led the South Africans in all 15 international matches. He led them in his first international, and only 2 others have done that. Basil Kenyon against New Zealand, 49. Des van Jaarsveld against Scotland in 60. Callard with a chance to stretch the lead. Oh, he's kicked it well. Straight as an arrow. Jonathan Callard with a penalty and a conversion. 10 points to five. Coming up towards half-time. So it isn't often that the South Africans have been behind on this tour. And of course, that remarkable effort of having scored 47 tries in the matches up to this one. And of course, they're desperately keen to play attractive rugby, but mainly to win, to finish on a triumphant note. Hasn't gone the 10 metres. Kruger takes it. No advantage to the Barbarians. Henny Leroux of the Transvaal. Used to play for Eastern Province. All of Ireland enjoying this spectacle. It's the 20th match between the Barbarians and major tour sides. They've won 6, lost 12, drawn 1. Pick up by Wainwright to back. Robert Jones going, there's a chance here out to Gagan. Gagan inside Henny Leroux. The interception by Van der Westhuizen. Robert Jones caught by his opposite number. And so really, the South African scrum half did great work there. But an electrifying run here by Simon Gagan. The little movement of his right foot, the acceleration away again, and the interception by Van der Westhuizen saved the day. Misa with the catch, going up Miles. Great jump by the big fella. And Dalton trying to throw Keith Wood. Coming in on the wrong side. That's up the side instead of behind. Pinar running. Almost up to halfway. Van der Westhuizen on to Kruger. Kruger, who's had a great tour. Neil Back did well to stay in his feet, but it's Van der Westhuizen to Leroux, Strauss, Pinar, Barbarians 10 metres line. Van der Westhuizen again, Leroux. Dummy switch to everybody, taken by Gavin Johnson. Good tackle by Hall, Barbarians 10 metres line. The counter attack and the drive. Again, the South Africans taking the ball in, unable to recycle it.
South Africa looking far more dangerous when they keep the ball tight with the big loose forwards driving in, and they look slightly out of sorts when they're trying to do the long miss move, which is giving the Barbarians defence time to realign.
Solid Barbarian scrummage. Robert Jones across the forwards. Gavin Johnson goes back. But it's one aspect there of the South African back play that in Gavin Johnson they have a fella playing on the wing who's accustomed to playing at fullback, and so his natural fullback skills are very well honed, as they were on that occasion. Derek Bevan very quick to nip round to the other side just to check that things are all right. Plenty of support for the South Africans here. Durant against Closey, Jones, Chalmers, again the miss move to Scott Hastings, in the line Saint-André once again. Back, gets it back to Jones, out to Hall. Hall, the chip kick through, Joubert going across. He may have a good ball, yes. I'll bet he was worrying in case he didn't get the extra bounce over the goal line. Because if he'd had to play it, there was real problem for him, but one feature of the South African play on the tour has been how cool they stay in defence. If you watch here, Hall really put in a very good kick indeed. It certainly beat Johnston. But if you watch, across here came Joubert, and he had a nice ball. Leroux, better effort. Huge jump by Shaw. Ian Jones. That was a dummy to the other big fellow, Jones. Wood once again. Caught by Kruger on the South African 10 metres line. Barbarians forwards are really rising to this occasion. Here's that big fella again, Manson Bishop. Robert Jones. Jones the dummy. Threw up to the 22. A great tackle by Durant, the prop forward on the 22. That was a superb covering tackle by, I think, the best drop forward on this tour. Loud blast for half-time, but watch this tackle. This is Robert Jones going, and that was a prop forward tackling him. Great cover work. Dalton in there as well. Rob Wainwright in there trying to rip it clear, but the South Africans have won it. There's James Dalton had the ball there, this chunky little South African hooker who's known as Bullock to his pals. Is 5 or 6 meters outside the Barbarians 22. Van der Westhuizen, he likes the narrow side. Callard underneath, good safe mark. Nothing to worry about there, a little bit late with the shoulder, and in fact the penalty has been given, so Van der Westhuizen has been penalised for that latest shoulder charge.
If they are going to pose a threat in the World Cup, then they'll have to improve the line-out play.
They're 10 metres outside the Barbarians 22. Wiese again with a magnificent jump. He really has caught well in that front position. And there's the drive. Tian Strauss meant to get it first of all. There, they're rolling it to the other side. They've got to keep them all moving. If it stops, they can't restart it. That's part of the law. But they're doing pretty well. Now the delivery. Van der Westhuizen, Leroux, out to Peter Muller, this is Mulder, and Joubert snatching a bit. He hasn't done that on tour so far, he's been so cool, calm and collected. But of course the pressure is intense, the Barbarians know who the danger men are.
Again, slight over, come the loop there, and Joubert, that he didn't look as though he wanted the ball. I don't know whether he was called to him, but certainly he wasn't running with any speed or enthusiasm onto it.
Robert Jones, Chalmers, charged down, got a second bite at it, still sliced it. Now this is Joubert going out to Mulder, Mulder on halfway. Wiese driving on, now the other big fellow Andrews. Now it's Leroux across, Strauss, Tian Strauss going. Lovely pass out there to Johnson, back into Strauss. Strauss all over the place at this stage. Van der Westhuizen trying to go the narrow side again, but the Barbarians have blocked that very well. Dalton going. Dalton almost clean through. Very important tackle by Robert Jones inside his own 22. Back there first. Now Van der Westhuizen again to Johnson. Johnson out to number 13. It's a try for Peter Muller. A loud blast. A very good try. Peter Muller, the scorer. A second try for the South Africans, they're all level.
Very similar try to the first one, that you see Dalton, that he's driven into the midfield, Van der Westhuizen gets it out, and there we see slight disappointment, I would think, by Saint-André and Wood there in the tackling, that you would have expected one of them to have got it, but again, good pressure. Go to the midfield, Johnson feeds it out, and Saint-André there, it doesn't really look as though he's full of enthusiasm to take him there. By the time Wood got there, it was too late. But again, punching in the midfield and coming back on the blind side.
Peter Muller, of course, with his third try of the tour, but a very powerful fellow. He's, what, 14 stone 8? And very difficult to stop. Meanwhile, Joubert. This to put South Africa in the lead, but he's pulled it. And so it stays at 10 points all. Van der Westhuizen had thought of going, but he got it away very well from out of the tackle to Johnson. And here it was a poor tackle by Philippe Saint-André.
I said that he takes the defenders. Joubert looks as though he could pass it out to Johnson. Chips ahead, and all it depends here is the bounce of the ball, because certainly Johnson takes it well, but it's set up nicely for him. But good work by Joubert, the fullback. Just look at the pace of those two lads going there, certainly outstripping Jonathan Collard. And it really was, as I said, just dependent on the bounce of the ball. He got a kind bounce,
kept himself low, which was important in for the score.
So the South Africans have scored three very good tries indeed. And their teamwork is beginning to tell. They've managed to withstand intense pressure. And now Gavin Johnston, who's now scored 69 points in 8 games on tour, 3 tries. Johnston pulling it across. He was practicing that for ages yesterday as well. But it's 15 points to 10 for South Africa, and Tian Strauss was the man who started it off. Then Van der Westhuizen made the threat, but it was that burst really that opened up the play. Callard was left behind by two very fast men indeed, and Johnston, who controlled himself so well. Good try. Referee about to whistle, but he's playing advantage. Jones, Chalmers, Howard. Good effort by Dalton, but a surge on there by Shaw. He's done some great work. The next big English look forward, surely, almost up to the South African 22. Jones once again, along the line there, indeed to the big fellow. It's back in there. There's a chance here for Hall. Hall chased by Kruger. A superb tackle by Kruger, the flank forward. That was the key issue there. Mike Hall with the surge first.
And we see a good hand by Howard, and now he's in a substitute. And Neil Back feeds it on well, but really Mike Hall, he was looking inside there, but nobody really rang with any conviction off his shoulder that Philippe Saint-André didn't really look as though he wanted the ball from there. But good work by Mike Hall.
Ian Jones of New Zealand at the line-out, standing at number 4, but it's Pienaar who takes it. It's a good ball for him to win. Going over the top and killing it, Van der Westhuizen out. There to Dalton. Dalton caught by Wood. The two hookers have been at it for much of the game.
I've enjoyed that battle more than anything else this afternoon.
Van der Westhuizen, Leroux. Strauss, who's been in great form. Great linker and... the interception there, and it could be a try for Howard. Howard all the way. Out there to Gagan. Gagan with the try. Of the blue, they've played 19 minutes of the second half. It's 15 all. Simon Gagan, who has scored 7 tries for Ireland, does it for the Barbarians and brings this 50,000 crowd to their feet.
You see the interception here. That good play by her, but look how he cuts back towards his support, realizes he's not going to make it, a little sidestep, and this is the most popular try of the afternoon. The golden boy of Irish rugby, Simon Gagan, going in for the try. But good awareness here by Howard. We see how he picks the ball up there from Van der Westhuizen, but then he cuts back, realises he's not going to make it, cuts back towards Gagan, and the whole place lifts off when this lad gets the ball and just cruises in for the most popular try this afternoon.
Callard to restore the lead. Yes, the East Stand told us all. The roar went up before the ball crossed the post. Callard's third successful kick. 17-15. Going into the last quarter. That East Stand, what an ovation they gave Simon Gagan as he went back after scoring. Stranstree's restart. Jones's jump. The crowd roaring every bit of good Barbarians play here. Robert Jones peers in. It's in there somewhere, he says. Almost got it. Got it now. Chalmers with the big one. Hasn't found his touch. Joubert, having got it from Stransky. And so Joubert had nothing on there at all. There was nobody back with him. But this was the interception. It was beautifully controlled by Howard, who, as I say, has played 3 times for Australia. And then it was that veer away that took him towards his man, Peter Muller, with the tackle. But Gagan with the catch. Lovely moment. You'll relish that for a long time. Good knock back by Wainwright. But Strauss, his opposite number, was up on it. Van der Westhuizen Leroux gives it to Mulder. Mulder looking for the forwards, who are a bit slow in getting back. The South African forwards looked a little bit fatigued there. Jones, Howard, and just a bit unlucky, a metre too far. Pat Howard there, who's really sparked off the Barbarians' back division.
That's right, there's one thing about an Australian, that they're competitive, and he's not here making up the numbers, he's here to win.
I noticed yesterday too at the practice session that he was the one with the quickest hands. Lisa again, but it wasn't straight, and the Barbarians will get the put in. Kubus Visa has had a very good afternoon at the front of the line-out. Barbarian scrummage, absolutely solid. Jones to Chalmers. Change of tactic. Howard through again. Caught by Muller. Muller tried to turn him. Won by Popplewell. Caught by Dalton. Offside.
A wry smile on the face of Nick Popplewell there, that normally props are penalised, and he's pleased to get one there. And Robert Jones, he just changes the ball here, because it's an important kick for Jonathan Collard here, that it's right in front of the post, but a bit of pressure on him, and but it should certainly within his capacity.
So the ball got apparently got ripped. May also have lost pressure. It's supposed to be, what, 9.5 to 10 pounds per square inch at sea level, Bill?
Well, if I did my geography, Dublin certainly at sea level.
Well, now a hush all round this crowd from the 50,000 crowd as Callard prepares to try to stretch the Barbarians' lead. Jonathan Callard, who played for Newport as an 18-year-old, and looks to have struck that one plumb, and it is. Like an arrow it went. Two penalty goals and two conversions for Jonathan Callard. It's 20 points to 15. They've 19 minutes left. And so the South Africans, hoping that they don't lose Joubert. He's gone back behind the post, but he seems to be just holding a leg a little. Meanwhile, Jonathan Callard. So stretch it to 8 points of the difference. Oh, you see it. He's hooked that one as well. He's clapped it. Johnston, oh, there's a massive kick by him. Hasn't found touch. Back underneath it. That's a typical forwards kick. Strauss. Joubert. Kruger going. Stransky came inside him. Wiese. Van der Westhuizen. That may be out in the full. Indeed it is.
Bad decision that by the scrum half, that they'd stretched the Barbarians wide. They had acres of space to the open side. What do they do? Hoof it off the field. Really, he'll be looking back at this and thinking, well, it wasn't my best decision of the tour.
12 minutes left. 5 points in it. They're on halfway. Ian Jones went up for it. Closey moves round. Dalton was offside. Jones, Chalmers, Chalmers saw the big space in behind Joubert. That could be the best kick of the match. A deafening roar from the crowd for that splendid kick. The Barbarians keeping the South Africans pegged down inside their 22. And just signs, Bill, maybe of a bit of tour fatigue.
Yes, I think they're looking a bit tired, but also you're seeing that the Barbarians are actually coming together. The more the game goes on, then the more they're aware of each other, and they're getting sort of a little bit better at the set pieces and a closer knit unit. And this is what happens as the game goes on. They're very much a scratch organisation, and they'll be delighted with the scoreline.
So the South African forwards move back a pace. If they all move together, it's acceptable. Wood gathers it in. Jones waits. Narrow side for Jones. Manson Bishop was the big fella who took it in further. Now it's Jones to Chalmers. Howard on the dummy run. Bit of misunderstanding. Back secures it. Strauss with the tackle. Drive on by Closey. He's tackled there by Andrews. There's real harem scarem stuff here as Robert Jones goes. The drop goal by Chalmers, surely. Is it going to squeeze over? It's hit the bar and it's gone over. No wonder there's a big smile on the face of Craig Chalmers, who dropped 7 goals on the British Lions tour in Australia. Dropped 3 goals in his first match for Melrose as a 17-year-old. The Barbarians in the lead, 23 points to 15.
Perfect ball again by Robert Jones, and it looks as though it's a bit like one of my drives up off the tee, but bounces off the crossbar. You don't happen to see that. I'll have to watch out for what happened next in question of sport there.
Back has it once more. Barbarians have got new life. Jones once again, Chalmers, Howard. Almost gets up to halfway, wriggling and squirming. Holding into the ball on the ground in the tackle. Kruger goes. Out there to Durant, almost up to the Barbarian 22. Not back the 10 metres. Dalton takes it quickly. Leroux nicely on there to Muller. Muller out to Johnston. Johnston running right across the face of the 22. A great run by him. A chance there as Joubert goes. Van der Vest hasten deep within the Barbarians 22. Now it's fed out from Strauss. Leroux, a real chance here for Mulder. Joubert is up with him. The fullback is in the line. There's no fullback at all for the South Africans. Durant out again. Wild pass from Leroux. Dalton in trouble. And if the Barbarians could win this ball, there's nothing in behind. Now there's a chance for Robert Jones going. Loud blast for going over the top. Tremendous excitement all round Lansdowne Road here. 23 points to 15, the Barbarians lead. And they've about 8 minutes left. An injury to Peter Closey. To injury time, there have been one or two injuries. Depends a lot on just how much the referee adds on for that. Popplewell is hurt. Nick Popplewell, this tremendously mobile Irish loose head prop forward. Notice there that Tian Strauss has moved across to between the lock forward and the flanker. And number 20, Rudolf Strowley, has gone into the flank forward position. He's also played as a number 8. Barbarians won't be sorry to re-scrummage. Time fading. A famous victory at hand. Ah, that was why Strauss back inside to Kruger. Van der Vestesen goes once more. Henny Leroux caught there by Hall and by Philippe Saint-André. The Barbarians' defence has been remarkable. The final whistle goes.